Hi friends, we are back with another professional update video. CBIC has enabled reset option for GSTR 3B in GST portal. This facility can be used only when the GSTR 3B has been submitted but not filed. CBIC notified that the B2C invoices issued by registered person whose turnover exceeds 500 crores in a financial year should contain the quick response code, that is QR code. This shall come into effect from 1st April 2020. CBIC has further notified that the registered persons whose turnover in a financial year exceeds 100 crores shall generate the B2B invoices only through the common electronic portal. For that, the CBIC has notified 10 websites through which the taxpayers can generate their e-invoices. This facility shall come into effect from 1st January 2020. ICA has announced that members in practice associating themselves with networks as a medium of referral of professional work is permissible only if such networks has been registered with ICAI. It is not permissible for the members in practice to join or associate themselves with the networks which are not registered with the institute. Otherwise, it will result in disciplinary proceedings in accordance with Chartered Accountants Act.
Late filing fee for delayed filing of income tax return up to 31st December 2019 is Rs. 5000. After that, late filing fee of Rs. 10,000 will be levied till 31st March 2020. In order to regulate the online sale of medicines comprehensively, the government has published draft rules for regulating of sale and distribution of drugs through e-pharmacy. India's foreign exchange overall net trade deficit is estimated at $54.06 billion for the year up to November 2019. Both the House of the Parliament has passed 15 bills to conclude the winter session of the year. This includes Citizenship Amendment Bill, Taxation Laws Amendment Bill 2019, etc. The NFRA, in their Audit Quality Review Report for the Statutory Audit for the Financial Year 2017-18 of ILNFS Financial Services Limited, has concluded that the auditor of that concern did not have adequate justification for issuing the audit report, assisting that the audit was conducted in accordance with the standards on auditing. Besides, the quality control system and processes were found to be severely inadequate and ineffective. Thank you for watching this video. We'll come again with another Medha minutes.